Hey hockey players, Coach Garner here from hockeytraining.com. In this video, I'm gonna run you through a push-pull core workout that's gonna hit every muscle group of the upper body to keep you strong on the puck and improve your shot power.
All right, let's get into this thing here. How this workout is broken down is into three different triplexes. A triplex is where you perform three exercises back to back to back, then you're gonna rest 2 to 3 minutes and then repeat that triplex 3 to 4 times before moving on to the next one. If that sounded at all confusing, don't worry about it. I've got all the sets, reps, and rest periods in the description below, so you can check that out. But right now, we're working on the flat dumbbell bench press. The flat dumbbell bench press is a great exercise to increase the working range of motion that the chest goes through in comparison to its barbell counterpart. Moreover, strengthening the chest, the anterior deltoids, and the triceps, which this exercise does, is great for staying strong on the puck and staying strong in front of the net. Once you're done the chest press, you're gonna head right over to your barbell bent over row. You're gonna do this one for 8 to 10 reps and utilize a pronated grip position or an overhand grip position. This exercise is one of the best bang for the buck exercises to train the posterior chain of the body. When you have a strong back, you have a hard shot. And when you have a strong back, you are hard to knock over on the ice because your postural strength is on another level. Drive the elbows straight back with every single rep and try and pinch your shoulder blades at the top of every single rep as well. To finish off this first triplex, we're gonna go with one-handed elevated medicine ball push-ups. I want you to do 10 to 12 per side, and this is a great exercise for your pressing muscles, very similar to the flat dumbbell bench press, but with this exercise, it's excellent for shoulder stability. A lot of hockey athletes have run into shoulder injury issues, and many times this isn't due to strength, but an overall stability of the shoulder girdle. You'll see Kevin's hand is shaking just slightly on that medicine ball, and that's because it's training the shoulder stabilizers in a very effective way. Hit 10 to 12 reps of this per side, rest, and then repeat for 3 to 4 rounds. Moving on to our second triplex, we're gonna utilize the exact same rep ranges as the first triplex, but we're gonna change our order of operations here. If you were watching carefully, the first triplex had a pressing movement, then a pulling movement, and then another pressing movement. We threw a pulling movement in the middle to give the pressing muscles a bit of a break in between exercises so that we didn't reduce performance on the pressing movements and that they got a little bit of a break to have more output by the end of the triplex. We're gonna do that in the exact same way for this second triplex, but for your pulling muscles. So in this one, we're gonna start with a pulling exercise, take a break with a pressing exercise, and then finish with another pulling exercise. The first exercise in this triplex is your seated cable row. With the seated cable row, don't be afraid to reach a little bit forward because I want you to feel a stretch in your lat, that huge muscle that's right near your armpit. You should feel a good stretch in that at the full length range of motion for every single rep. And then drive the elbows straight back, pinch the shoulder blades at the back of the movement, and that would be a complete and proper rep. Repeat that 6 to 8 times. Up next, we have our standing dumbbell shoulder press. This is exactly as it sounds. You put a couple of dumbbells in your hand, stand up, stand strong, have a good posture, drive the dumbbells straight up, and then lower them down with control. I like standing versions of overhead presses better than seated versions because it forces you to keep your core stable and strong throughout the movement and not rely on a bench or on the ground to help keep you stable. Hockey is a total body sport and you're gonna need to be stable no matter what position you're in. So anytime you're doing overhead presses, I recommend to do the standing version. To finish this second triplex off, we're gonna rep it out with 10 to 12 reps per side of the one-arm dumbbell row. The one-arm dumbbell row is a great way to train the lats, the rotator cuffs, and your grip strength, which for hockey players means improving your slap shot power. Moreover, since you're only loading one side of the body, there's an additional excellent core stability training stimulus with this exercise that goes very under-respected and unnoticed by a lot of coaches out there. One-arm dumbbell rows are great for core stiffness and core stability. Do this through a full range of motion, drive that elbow straight back, and really try and pull your shoulder blade towards your spine at the end of the movement. All right, it's time to finish this workout off with a bang. Our last triplex includes push-in muscles, pulling muscles, and core muscles all in one shot. You're gonna begin with the dumbbell renegade row. With the renegade row, you're essentially just gonna get in a push-up position, but holding dumbbells, and then you're gonna row them up 6 to 8 per side. This exercise forces you to have extreme core stability, and that's one of the hardest parts about this exercise. We've already fatigued the back, so we can use the renegade row at the end with a lower weight and still get a great training stimulus, but also massively emphasize core stiffness, which helps improve every single aspect of hockey performance. Once you've finished up your dumbbell renegade rows, you're going to move right into alternating stability ball step-offs. Here, you're going to do 8 to 10 reps per side, and this is another great exercise for core stability. You see the inner core muscles are getting hit a lot in this workout, but also training the body in a unilateral sense as well, meaning we're ensuring that we're training the core, but we're also getting structural balance out of the deal because each side is loaded individually as you do your full 8 to 10 reps per side. Keep your butt in the air, keep nice and level, and touch your toes to the ground every single rep. All right, it's time to finish this workout and this triplex off with a little bit of everything. We're using our pulling muscles, we're using our pushing muscles, and we're using our core muscles. Also, you're getting a little bit of a conditioning effect out of this because if you watch Kevin, I want you to move as fast as he is moving in this as well. So you're creating a total body conditioning effect and really just tapping off all the resources in these muscles to ensure you send the training stimulus home. Squat right down below parallel, curl on your way up, and then press directly overhead without letting the dumbbells get too far in front of you. Repeat that 10 to 12 times, and you are done this workout. Thanks for watching our hockey training video. If you liked that video, smash that thumbs up button and subscribe to our channel. And for more information on how you can become the best hockey player you can possibly be, I want you to click that link in the comment section because I've got more content just like this, full hockey training programs, and everything that you need to become a faster, more conditioned, and better overall hockey athlete just waiting for you. Click on that link in the comment section and let's get at it.